And now, The Bonfire with Big J. Oakerson and Dan Soder.
It's still fun, Daniel.
Goddamn right it is.
It is also The Bonfire, Comedy Central Radio, Sirius XM 95. It is Tuesday. I'm back, Big J. Oakerson.
From Hollywood.
Whoop-de-whoop. What?
Filming pay cable. That's all we do here at The Bonfire. We have subway cards, and we on pay cable.
Is that Ric Flair? No, that, of course, is the handsome and hilarious Dan Soder.
I was trying to do Ric Flair, bud.
Huh?
Yeah, I was trying to do a Ric Flair-esque. Or is this still the fucking cheese store from Tony Danzer?
Yeah, we found out.
We found out so much information.
Tony Danzer runs a cheese store. Doesn't want to talk about it.
Which is super suspect.
Yeah.
Hey, don't bring up my cheese store.
No, you think. Hey, I don't make the cheese myself.
You know, I took a lot of the Who's the Boss money, put it into a cheese store. You have a...
Milano would come by every now and again.
You were gone. And the last show, live show that we did was last Wednesday, and we ended as Mirror Image started.
I mean, they took the stage. They stormed the stage is what happened.
Yeah, and you saw their father doing the fake clap in the back.
I don't have a problem going back, and let's refresh you with their interview.
Oh, you want to start from the second interview again?
I do, actually.
Big J watching America's Got Talent on NBC and discovers Mirror Image, which are two twins. Who they're teenagers. They're very cocky, I would say.
Very
self-assured.
Very cocky. I'd say what they're very not, though. Not gay, apparently, as one claims to have a 4-year girlfriend. Where does she live? I think Canada, where they met at summer camp.
Yeah. She writes me all the time. It's super, it's like steamy stuff.
She's so like, she gets like so wet in her pussy for me.
It's like weird. She told me she wishes I could stick my dick in the email, and I'm like, there's no way to do that. And
then she asked me, loves my big fat cock.
Gay guys talking straight dirty. Alright, let's hit play. So this is it from
our Mirror Image, and we're back.
You know what it is?
Crazy.
It's the corny smile and the faces that they make that really upset me. I've decided these are teenagers.
It's not the fact that they dance like a gay couple.
Hey, whatever. That's fun.
And they're twins?
Hey, why not? Twins are in weird shit.
Wonder Twin Powers! Activate!
Lou, did you and Stu ever dance in the living room in front of your dad?
No, we're straight.
So are these kids. What are you saying?
I feel like Lou's is a Goodwill Hunting story where he's all like, we had to dance. What do you want me to tell you, huh? That Will, the guy, all the praise because they're flicking hot embers at us?
I've been getting this my whole life. Shut up.
Oh, my God. Just Lou and Stu go around serving motherfuckers all over Bayonne.
The boys of Bayonne.
The boys of Bayonne.
Yeah, just wrecking shop.
Oh, just you guys doing the kid and play dance?
Stu. Goes, come on, Stu. We got to go dance. Stu goes, I can't. I got school.
Don't stop, body rock. Stu and Lou is here to drop.
Young Lou, I just love women.
Oh, just fucking, Lou would just DJ while his brother fucking did knee spins.
Oh, here we go. Ladies and gentlemen. And he would talk all through scratching. We'd be like, it's Will. It's Will. They go, one of you boys can dance like a maniac. The other one don't talk a lot, but he's good with his hands.
Oh, yeah. Was that your brother? Did they call him Double Dub? Was that his dance name?
No.
Double Dub?
No, the two Stews.
Ah, two Stews.
Oh, I like yeah. DJ Lou and Double Dub.
Yeah, Double Dub and DJ Lou.
Double Dub's dancing.
He goes, now watch. Lou, two. Man, your throwback, the throwback twins act.
Fort Lee is in the house.
These kids rock a party like I've never seen before, bro. Too bad there's not a talent show on a major network that you could use to make money off of it.
Can I tell you by the reaction we're getting right now? Just, again, my people reading skills. Stu and Lou.
Yeah.
Definitely did what you're doing right now. Definitely, because he put this song on. There's a reason he chose this song. I remember him telling me he likes this song before. And Stu and Lou absolutely had a dance thing worked out to this when they were younger.
Do you think there was ever a angry, winded conversation after their dance routine in the kitchen?
I think it was all confidence together.
Where they come inside and they go, what happened to you on that last part? No, Mom looked away. And then you were supposed to do the kick, and I was going to duck under and go over you. What happened? You didn't hit it. We had to go right back into it. Okay, you ready? Mom, Dad, hold on. Cue up the second song. Okay, you ready?
Are you going to go out there and fucking embarrass yourself? Okay. And me? In front of that crowd?
Yes. The knee slides, they cause a lot of static energy, and I zapped you when I did that tuck touch. My tuck touch. So I was going to need you to go out there. I'm going to need you to nail it. Okay, ready? One. Hey, Mom, Dad! Coming through the swinging door.
Hey, I know me and Stu are here, and we just want to tell you that we ain't here to hurt nobody. Oh. Hey!
Aw, oh, yeah.
You see the intro part, Mom? You just see, though, for the intro part, we'll be talking normally. Oh, and here we go. And then just fucking Stu comes sliding between your legs.
Dad, they ever rap about it?
Dad,
I want to talk to you about allowance.
Your two big boys are here to dance and do this. Get it in your
face. Wait, start this over again, though, because he does the sexy talk to his mom. Where he goes, hey, Lou, start the song over again. So they come out, because he goes,
Aw, yeah,
Mom. Your meatloaf last night was slamming. Also, Dad, good job mowing the lawn. I can see the lines in it.
Mom, your macaroni and cheese is D to the O to the P to the E.
Did an R&B breakdown to your mom?
Oh,
yeah.
Girl.
I'm talking about a sweet old angel.
You've been fold my undies for years.
Yeah. I just want to say every Mother's Day, I wish it was like that every day.
Earth Day is Mother's Day.
Let's go to these twins, because I'm a much bigger fan of the Witzke twins.
Me too.
Tap dancing.
Yeah, you didn't know we tap danced?
Hold on, bring that up. It's just some empty VFW and Will and Lou.
Yeah. All right, Stu, ball heel kick.
Just in the corner.
Now, big flails. And take it home. Come on, fucking Baryshnikov. Let's do this. Come on, you know, Gregory Hines, Uncle Gregory.
He goes, and they stop, and the bartender goes, hey, if your boys are going to dance, you got to buy more than a beer.
You can't stop me from doing what I do. Will, okay. All right. Now we step on the chairs. Jump down. Okay. All right. Now. Oh, God. All right. Now, the big tails in your Cab Calloway suit are flaring up. They're flipping up. Your sock cuffs. Sock garters are coming down.
Ain't that the Witsky boys from down the street? What's the dad making them do?
Whoa, I knew those kids was different. I didn't know they was both a couple of fagos. What are they doing over there?
What do you think? They take baths together? Think they be kissing?
A couple of fanooches over there, you know what I'm saying? Hey, Papa Witsky, what are you blowing there, pink sperm or what? What's up?
Hey, Joe Jackson, what do you got going on over there? hey, Christine, hit place on our favorite pyramid.
Easy. We just tore it up. We tore the floor.
Two gay twins danced for you.
Mel B's easily blown away.
She is.
Oh, my God. What the hell was that?
No, I told you I hate this. Pretty girls are just so excited to see gay people do something, and they want to keep them. It's got nothing to do. She doesn't respect them as, like, your performance. She goes, oh, my God, I could put you all in my purse.
Oh, my God, I'd love to put a leash on you and feed you.
Oh, can I hang you two fruits in my house?
Oh, I know where I'd put you.
Hit play.
Thank you. I didn't think the singing was great. I thought dancing was terrible. I'm going to have to say no.
Good job, Simon.
So this round, our number one goal is to definitely win over Simon. We're adding new harmonies, bigger dance moves, and an overall just amazing performance.
We are actually going to dock halfway through.
I know it's never been done before, but I am going to enter him from behind, and then I'm going to sing from the inside, and you will hear our voices doubled coming through him.
How crazy is that?
Vibration sciences. We figured this out in our weird gay room.
We've been finding it out in our finished basement that we use as the fuck dojo.
They keep sending us down real dance instructors, but we keep sucking them off and sending them away.
Like a monster that needs to be fed that lives in the basement, a two-headed monster.
I'm the deep throater, and then what no one sees coming is then fucking Nathan comes behind and starts licking your bum like a kitten.
You ever had your salad tossed while you're getting sucked off, mister?
By the same exact face? You can look down, or you can look in the mirror. You're seeing the back and front of the same goddamn face.
It's like being on a roller coaster and skydiving.
Am I in deep space? Is this 2001 Space Odyssey hallucinations? Or am I getting my talent tossed?
We call it a double DMT, because you feel like you're dying.
Oh, God. This dual bicycle, really.
Since we've been on the show, we went back to school, and it's been crazy.
Lou, did you and Stu ever do tandem bike? Ever?
Actually, yes, we owned one, but it got stolen.
Oh, what a fucking New Jersey ending to a sweet story.
I mean, you know what it was? It was whoever the evil twins are in the neighborhood.
Who are the evil twins? Wario and Luigi?
I didn't know about our nemesis.
You did have a tandem bike though, for real?
Yeah, it was like a 70s one. I don't think we ever rode it together though, because it got stolen so quickly.
You rode it alone?
No. Oh, the saddest,
that's the fucking weirdest thing.
The saddest twin in the world? He goes, nah, he's around. He don't want to ride bikes with me.
He's getting pussy, I guess.
He's like, I don't know. I'm not allowed in the bedroom when he has a friend over.
I'm just taking our now extraordinarily hard to navigate bicycle.
He goes, plus size, I'm going to have some melon sized calves with this whole thing. I'm going to have some Mike Allstock calves.
Bikes are obviously made for twins. Now I look stupid.
That's fucking really great. You and did you ever dress the same?
Yeah, that's why we hated each other.
How long did your mom make you dress alike?
Until we were like five, matching big wheels, matching everything. We were totally same outfits, and then that's why we rebelled against each other and fucking wanted to choke each other.
Yeah, because you're basically being told to be one person.
Yep, that's what you don't do.
Yeah. Well, these guys fucking...
And then you liked Pearl Jam. And then your brother just started sucking off on that too, huh?
Yeah, well, we were friends by then. I got him into it.
He took Pearl Jam from you.
That's hilarious, Christine.
Because now, I always say, New Jersey's number one Pearl Jam fan. The double dub.
That's the double dub. Dub dub?
It's double dub.
People are not saying that.
I think a lot of people are saying
that. Who's saying that?
They are. They said he bought the CD from every city on the South American tour.
Oh!
Chile.
God.
Chile, 2001.
How do you know that? That's the wrong year, but it's true. They did play Chile.
Jay, if you look at the picture Christine brought up of Mirror Image, they are wearing the Arizona green T-shirts.
Oh, look at that. Well, yeah, I mean, basically just a cherry blossom, right?
Yeah, it's a cherry blossom shirt.
Oh, no.
Did you ever wear twin cherry blossom shirts?
Oh, if I wanted to crush as much pussy as these guys do, I would.
But I wanted to go out womanizing, of course.
Oh, God, I don't know how they could walk.
I mean, if I was going to fucking fuck them and flee, yeah. Hell yeah. My pump dump outfit.
My pump and dump outfit. I call these two the California raisins because they're drained of all their fluids. They're so busy fucking.
We have no more cum or water in us.
We can't wait like a college wrestler.
All my salts are in this girl. I'm just constantly pumping out cum because we get ass.
She's like a full sponge of cum.
These aren't lesions. They're hickeys from all the girls sucking our bodies.
And the Philadelphia when they've given them each other, when they've given each other AIDS.
Lesions? How dare you? These are cigarette burns. I'm really into some dark shit, man.
Because my brother and I fuck real sluts. Real sluts. I mean, I'm talking about spit on it before they're even working it.
This is true.
It's reminding me of somebody we know. Like really over chatting up.
Oh, it really does this.
Over chatting up, like how much pussy you get when you're clearly gay.
Yeah, like
that's so funny.
Love it.
He goes, I'm just being sickly into it. Clearly dying of AIDS.
I take this cocktail because a man can only get so many boners, and when it's just rain and sniz on me like it is. I need a little bit of help to get it up.
Have you ever, played around in a pool and your friend keeps you under the water a little too long? That's how it is with me and pussy juice all the time. I'm just drowning in it. I fuck so much.
Boop, 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 boop.
Time. Oh, that's my alarm. I gotta go. Take my...
I honestly... I think I'm so good at fucking pussy. God's a woman, and she wants to... have me fuck her. I'm gonna go to that pussy in the sky.
Look out, God's pussy. Here comes... Macho.
Alright, let's get back to the fucking Mirror Image.
Watch out, God's pussy. Here comes Mirror
out, even the teacher
Image.
Boy, they're like, gosh, how's Tyra? And I'm like, she's great.
Okay, that had no ending.
Yeah, cherry blossom.
Go back, please. Lou, I need you to actually make, like, a real... Sometimes just, like, the way... This sounds like a... fucking stone pothead conversation, but just the cadence of words. Mm-hmm. I love, for some reason, it makes me laugh so hard when he goes, how's Tyra? I go, she's right. Yeah. It's like they're weird little no. Like they say no after things, like I'm joking.
Yeah.
They do so much of that. That cadence makes me laugh hard.
When Tyra talks about their shirts, they go, that's the cherry blossom. We'll run a train on you. No.
But say, when you let yourself, you feel that what you're saying is bombing before it ever gets any response to you go, it's like, oh yeah, because, you know, we're super macho.
It's almost a Chris Farley-esque thing.
So many people do that.
Our teachers are like, what is everyone like? And I'm like, everyone's pretty awesome.
It's like, are you guys princes? And I go, yes, we are princes. Yeah.
He said, are you going to win it? I said, are we going to win it? I said, we're going to win it 2 years in a row. Then they ask me, do I have violent thoughts? And I say, all the time I think about ending my brother.
People say, do you guys think you're the best? And it's just like... Yes, I know.
People ask, like, would you ever be capable of domestic terrorism? And I'm like, yes.
Do I look?
There's
a fucking trail off of my favorite thing. And they're always kind of like, do you like to suck cock? I go, who doesn't like to suck cock?
Yeah.
No.
You
Yeah, no, they asked me, like, do you watch your brother sleep? And I'm like, of course I watch him sleep. And then I put a pillow over his face. No, I didn't see what I'm getting you.
Do you want to kill your, people are like, do you want to kill your parents? Because they make you guys dress the same. And it's like, oh, yeah, I want to kill him dead.
People ask me, they say, do you idolize the Menendez brothers? And I say, people, yes, we are.
People are like, Tyra's so hot, do you want to have sex with her? I go, yeah.
Because that's right at the moment he does that.
Like, she's great.
What is this called? Okay.
Cherry blossoms. Watch, they do.
Look at that.
They've been watching the show since they were babies.
That dad is forcing every smile.
They're going to pump it out. I know they are.
He goes,
it is our biggest dream to make it to the live shows, to get to perform live in front of America at the Dolby Theater. There's no stopping us.
There probably is after this round.
They'll do it. They'll do it here. Now,
I like that the sponsors just have the giant cups, so they just look like pieces of shit drinking big old Dunkin' Donuts.
Yeah. They're all drinking water, like bottled water.
Fucking New Englanders. Just,
fuck you queer twins. I got my fucking Dunkin'. All right. Let's see what you fucking fairy twins got, huh?
Oh, God. Luckily.
Oh, Nancy and Nancy.
Oh, yeah. You're lucky there's no fucking hockey players up there to pull those queer shirts over your head and beat on you like a fucking drum.
Welcome back.
Thank you.
I think I remember the last time we met.
I was you got pissing three... on you.
This is one note.
Yeah.
How did you think the first audition went?
I think it went pretty well, but I think this one is way better.
Exactly.
Okay.
I made it better for you.
Thank you.
No, but I didn't.
Stage, you've seen the competition. You still feel confident that you can progress to the next round?
I think everyone is amazing.
Yeah.
And it's hard to judge a singer and a person that does...
He goes, also, do you feel like if a woman's vagina was in front of you, you could become erect? They go, yes.
I mean, if a hot chick's vagina was right here, I mean, I would get so hard.
I don't know. Is it Mel B? No, probably not, because I like boys. All right.
Hand balancing and people that stand at each other's necks with shovels. But I feel we have something different and special, and I feel we need to show America.
Well, you're definitely different.
Thank you. We're special.
I agree.
My mom thinks I'm special. No.
I agree. And when
my mom thinks I'm special. No.
But he also, he stole his brother's joke. His brother, he's a hack.
Yeah.
His brother made the joke and then that.
You get way backstage and he goes, hey, Tim, can I talk to you real quick?
Behind the curtain real quick.
Did we stop being a duet at some point?
He turns it off. He goes, Tyra, we'll be right there.
Tyra, you better watch out or I'm going to steal you from whoever you're dating.
One quick second. I have to talk to my twin. Can I get a word with you?
Yeah. What was that? I told you I was going to lead with the my mom thinks I'm special joke. You know I lead. You back me up with some light pitter patter.
Hey, man, we're both out there busting ass, okay?
He goes, you think Dad wanted to pull me from fucking tech school? Huh? I was working on goddamn Mustangs, living the time of my life. He wanted something for you, and I'm here, acting like a fucking queef.
8-1. 8-1, Dan. I walked away from an 8-1 MMA career. Because you said, we're going to go on AGT, and we're going to get $1 million gig doing what we love, gay dancing, as twin brothers in Vegas.
He goes, and you know that half the population that watches this show doesn't even believe Pamela exists? My girlfriend of the past 4.5 years? It's the mother of my child. No one believes that she exists, because I got to act like you.
We're going to need you guys to say it. He goes, okay, we'll be out. We're being fashionably late. No.
If
you just close the door, please, that'd be absolutely great. Hey, now you fucking get your head out of your goddamn ass, jerk
off. You're not going back to Pittsburgh empty-handed.
Dad, I'm not fighting Tommy Lupo in the fucking streets anymore. We're going to get Ma and get the fuck out of that goddamn dump.
You think I like them living in a townhouse in the black part of town? I'm getting them out of there.
Now you fucking button one more button on that cherry blossom shirt, and you go out there and you flare off to America.
He goes, look at me. Ready? 1, 2.
Mirror image. Let's get him a mirror. Yeah. Go back where he makes the joke.
You can come live with me. I feel we have something different and special, and I feel we need to show America.
Well, you're definitely different. Right.
Thank you. We're special.
I agree.
My mom thinks I'm special. No.
I agree. And when your mom thinks you're not special anymore, you can come and live with me.
Thank you, Heidi.
And when your mother decides to get rid of you, and she inevitably will, I've got some experiment.
Christine calls that. She goes, are you familiar with twin math of Germany?
At a certain age, there can be only one, like a Highlander.
She's ah,
I take you home and feed you to Seal. Seal only eats twins on our anniversary.
I know what you're thinking. His teeth aren't sharp enough.
He swallows you all if you digest inside of him.
Heidi Klum is some sort of fucking Bond villain like that. It's so great.
What have I told you? Seal can eat both of you in one bite. In 3 days, you will be completely digested. And Seal will be nothing of you.
Would I like to meet Seal? No.
I guess that does sound like a kiss from a rose. And I was like, yeah. But I can't
believe I said it. I don't even really mind it. I mean, look at the pose. Every time, Christine, just go back there and just hit on and off pause over and over again. You can't catch them not in a completely gay pose.
But I feel we're something different and special.
Pause.
Yeah. And I feel.
Do you hear, I just want to see him steal his brother's mind one more time. Right here. Yeah. All right.
Thank you.
There it is.
I agree.
My mom.
I mean, legitimately, right after the other one, just steals it. Also, them tucking the front of their shirts into their khaki pants is bugging the fuck out of me.
They're like khaki sweatpants.
No.
I agree. And when your mom thinks you're not special anymore, you can come and live with me.
Oh, thank you, Heidi.
Because I love to be double-teamed by gay twins. It's the most model thing ever. Mm-hmm. Two men are not attracted to women have sex with you. If you drink the sperm from a man who does not want to put it on you, you'll gain 10 years of existence. I am 745 years old. I've been fucking gay twins.
The G's of the gay twin
are wunderbar.
This was fun.
Here we go.
Oh, there's my son.
Oh, the leaves are brown.
Okay.
And the sky is gray.
Do you know how much pause it? Do you know how many applause breakouts there are when these guys do this in, like, their school assembly? But there is a faction of black kids who literally have the principal just sits them down once a year and goes, all right, guys,
look, talent shows next Friday.
Guys, look.
You know what's coming.
You know this guy goes, I need you to not roll these kids every single day.
Okay, first on.
I need you to be really cool.
Your laugh cannot be as piercing as it has been the last two assemblies.
I will guarantee you all straight C pluses.
If you do not heckle these boys, they are upperclassmen now. They're juniors, so you have to show them a little respect. But I'm telling you right now, when they harmonize, please do not yell out.
Now, you going to tell me I can't say nothing about these booty kisses, and you going to give me straight C-plus?
Principal, come on.
Principal,
come on.
You got to come a little more now.
Come on.
I get C-plus in my speech. Dude, you know, they're super smart.
How funny it would be to, like, have them at an inner-city school do, like, the assembly just to see if they can make it, like, Alive at the Apollo.
Oh, my God.
Live at the Apollo would be incredible with these two.
Why can we not make that happen?
Because we don't want to get them murdered.
They're not going to be murdered at the Apollo.
TV.
They might win. They might fight. No, they won't. But
they go up there and just start humping the wood, yeah, the piece of wood.
Everyone's just shocked. Yeah.
She goes, oh my God, he goes, are we fucking the wood or is the wood fucking us? No,
he's getting air respect to the Apollo, but then I don't.
Hit play. Simon's not impressed.
I've been for a while.
Their voices are wretched to me.
Oh. God, I hate their faces.
You see the other ones doing the high pitch? California dreaming. Here's where they totally fruit out.
Fruit it out, boy!
By the way, pause it, Christine.
Oh, shit.
Being judged by DJ Khaled, of all people.
DJ Khaled, yeah. He's riding jet skis. We the best, though!
I mean, it's so funny.
You the gayest, though! Is this DJ Khaled?
He's got to watch this and take it seriously.
Dude, that is so funny that they're like... The people that had to live in the hotel room next to them when they were creating that song
must have been.
Here's some businessman from Buffalo that's just trying to sell stuff. He's like, yeah, I don't know, Lucy. I can't go to bed because these two fucking idiots are trying to harmonize California Dreaming.
That's my 1408. You ever seen the movie 1408?
Yes. I know what you mean. Where they're like, I can never sleep. They're always doing a brand, their version of California Dreaming.
Oh, you can check in, but you can't check out. No.
We want to play with you forever and ever. No, I'm just kidding. It's not forever.
We got a
kick on. I don't know. We can't go back. We should take our first break because this is, I didn't think we were going to burn through a half hour on this.
Oh, and we'll stop right before this is about to kick into fucking queer gear. It's the bonfire.
And now, back to the bonfire with Big J. Oakerson and Dan Soder.
Oh, yeah. It's all family music on the bonfire.
David Cassidy and the Partridge Family.
Yeah, the Partridge Family, see?
They weren't really family.
I know, but a TV family. It's the Bonfire, Comedy Central Radio, Sirius XM 95. I'm Dan Soder. That's Big J. Oakerson at the Bonfire SXM on Twitter, Instagram, and Snapchat. We are, of course, watching probably our favorite, least favorite duo, Mirror Image. Like, it's our favorite...
How dare you?
But we love watching them.
Oh, my God. I would watch them do a three-hour Corey Feldman-esque concert. Absolutely.
Oh, man.
What they believe they could put together for 3 hours, I would watch.
Don't you wish you were...
And by the way, I would watch it and, like, I'd have to be physically restrained. Like, I'd have to be like... You have to, like, hold me down from, like, throwing things to the stage.
Come on!
Or laughing.
If you were an eccentric billionaire, would you hire them to perform at your birthday party?
Oh, yeah, and I would shoot blanks at their feet.
Creep dance! Oh, you'd be like Albert Molina and Boogie Nights?
Yeah, but I would not blanks, rubber bullets.
Ooh, okay. What about beanbag bullets? I feel like, what hurts more, rubber bullets or beanbag bullets?
Probably rubber bullets hurt more.
Yeah.
So I'll do riot bullets.
What about tasers?
I'm not gonna hurt them, I just wanna let them know I'm there and I'm hitting them.
What about a taser?
I want confirmed hits. No, I'm not gonna tase them.
Paintball gun. That's the most humane one, because then you see where you hit him.
It is, but I want to, you'll see with the beanbag. The beanbag will hurt for sure, but I don't
want... And they're like, hey, you knocked the wind out of me, but it's okay.
You can get him in the pelvis, like, mid-cartwheel. Come on, dude.
It's like shooting one of those duck plates at the carnival.
Yes, exactly like that.
All right.
Back up a little bit so we can make sure they finish up the slow part.
I believe, man.
Look at that. I mean, they cannot be paused in a not gay pose.
Well, there's two of them, so there's just more, the odds are higher for one of them making a gay face.
It's never that one of them looks super masculine, Dan.
Look at him on the left. What a cowboy.
Excuse me? I said, get your hands off that young lady. No,
I'm your Huckleberry. No, but I'm not really. I'm just kind of a guy.
It's hard being a cowboy in this hot heat with these leather pants.
I have two guns, one for each of you. No, I don't. I only have one gun. I'm not sure I can shoot it. Oh, I hate it.
Back it up, Christine. The one doing the... is my favorite thing so far. You don't have to go that far back.
She goes to the beginning of the interview, you're like, hey,
right there, I'd be good. And the sky
is gray. Simon, very unhappy. For a while. It's not good. On a winter's day. And I can't sing for shit. I'll be safe and warm. be great if in the middle of it goes, hey, knock it the fuck off, dude.
We're supposed to be singing together.
Stop it.
You
this, fucking monster. What, I hate you.
What's the wording I'm using? I don't want to just make it sound like we're just arbitrarily shitting on it. They're in rhythm. What is I'm looking for? Like they're singing
harmony. Are they harmonized?
They're harmonized. They're singing like in a key, like steadily.
Falsetto.
Yeah, no. I know they're falsetto. But I'm not saying that. I'm just saying like I don't want to make it sound like they're just like they're not coming out and going like California Dreaming on such a winter's day. Like they're singing. Like they're definitely singing consistently.
Me and my twin Stan.
But I don't want to hear the noise.
California Dreaming.
But I don't want to hear the
California Dreaming.
Oh God, that hurts my face. That's how they sing.
Oh my God, is that chicken crow?
You just upstairs the dad, you just hear his revolvers. Nothing.
I don't know if I got the best luck or the worst luck. Hey, ladies.
I don't know.
You want to do pizza for dinner?
No, Dad, we don't want to do pizza. Sorry, Dad, we're not going to carbo load.
There you go. All right, I'm going to go try to meet the angel of death again.
I'm going to go turn on the riding mower on random and just lay down in the yard.
Hope that thing picks me up like a Roomba.
I'm gonna go ghost ride the rotted mower and
all right.
Lay down on the ground.
I'm gonna go on I-40 and play Fight Club and just let go of the wheel. See if I wake up in a bed at home. All right, you ninnies, take care.
Okay. Hey, Dad, make sure you wear a seatbelt.
Oh, Sarah McPants is a genius. Perfect opening act for Corey and his angels. Corey's angels.
Oh, the angels.
His angels.
My angels and my angels. I'm really filled out.
What if I told you I had a new brand of young boys who like boys? Who like boys, who like girls, who like boys.
I know what guys like. I know what twins want. Twins want
dog.
Twins want. Twins want dick. Meow, meow, meow.
California Dreaming.
You're so dramatic.
On such a winter's day.
I feel like they sedated DJ Khaled.
Oh! What? Oh, God. What is this?
What isn't it? Perfect? Simon's getting closer to Heidi Klum just to be less gay.
He just starts kissing her. They all know that they suck. They're all referencing that they suck.
Pause it. DJ Khaled.
God, oh, what the fuck is that? Can you please take a picture of that? Because I have no clue.
It's an ass.
Oh, God.
Think about it for a second.
It's four guys in a fucking dumpster.
Yeah.
I thought it was four little people.
No. That'd be great.
Quick look.
Christine's dream. Four little people. They are DJ Khaled right now, I believe, is inside reminding himself he's on national television.
Yes, I'm telling you, it's a publicity crisis in his head right now.
He has to be his own Ray Donovan right now. Yeah, there's no fixing this.
Come on, Khaled. You say the wrong thing, they take away all those.
It's live. It's over. If you say the wrong thing, it's over.
He goes, come on, man. You on NBC. You say the wrong thing, this is done.
Oh, man. Go ahead. Who buzzed? Wait, back up a little bit. Somebody buzzed.
Dude, when they start dancing,
that's a great picture.
It's just flailing. Yeah, you could see his whole conversation goes, all right, so we the best though, but they not the best though.
He's like, I have a son. I don't want to go to jail for a hate crime.
He goes, do I call him what I'm thinking?
He goes, does it now? I mean, if my dick starts to get hard, I can kill them, right?
Yeah, he goes, do they know Middle East law? We break their head with stones. I mean, there it is. Wait, good job, Simon. Simon did.
Oh, is it Simon?
Yeah. Wait, Christine, back up a little bit and pause it right before he runs to him. Again, take a picture of that and send it out. Not that. Right before, right? I mean, look at the fucking, look at his face.
Yeah. He's like, yeah, I'm going in for it, bro.
Here we go. Everything we've ever worked for.
God, we'll put you demon.
I mean, yeah, this is,
I mean, they're tight pants, no socks, I mean, everything. Their father isn't proud of them. I just know he's not.
If he is, he has the lowest.
I don't want to argue. I don't want to have him call on the show to defend that he is.
Good news,
of course,
he's
going to say.
Good news is our dad has the lowest standards possible. No, but seriously, every day is a waking nightmare.
It's great. My dad always wanted two daughters.
I'm just kidding. He's got two sons, but he treats us like daughters.
All right. Dad, can we get money for full body waxes before AGT?
Dad, you said you won!
We know our dance moves work better if we're completely hairless!
You know, if your older brother Kevin would have never been killed, this would never have been happening.
Dad, can we get money?
I want to move out. I want to start a new family. That's what I would say if I was your dad. Alright, hit play. Yeah! Simon's out. Shut up, Tyra.
I mean, that's...
Mel B
stands up.
Oh, really?
And creates a standing ovation. Look at the dad is so embarrassed to be standing up.
He goes, fuck.
He's like, fuck. And they're gonna put the camera right in my goddamn face again.
You make me feel really good inside. Forget that ex. You've got us. You've got me rooting for you.
Thank you so much.
Thank you.
Fuck you.
Performing, it was so much going on. Like, I'm trying to figure it out, like. So I'm looking.
He goes, hold up, though, but like, for real, like, y'all brothers, but do you fuck? He goes, that ain't the question.
Now, I'm gonna be honest with y'all right now.
That's the question I didn't want to ask. I mean, that's what I was thinking, but I didn't want to ask that.
All right, now, I'm gonna be honest with y'all. I escaped into my mind for most of that performance.
He goes, I had to do a lot of personal inventory during that entire dance number. So I guess my question is, y'all don't fuck.
What do y'all do?
Oh, man.
You guys are a gay couple, right?
I want you to know that if worst case scenario, I would eat your brains like monkeys.
Okay.
So what I'm saying is, my answer would be very interesting.
Thank you.
Whatever. I don't know what's happening.
That was as diplomatic as he could be.
Look, I thought the whole thing was mad, but that's why we have five people on the panel. Good luck. And we'll see what happens later on. Thank you very much.
I'm fighting for it.
They moved on?
They move on!
Oh, dude, that means we get a third dosing.
Oh, dude.
Did it already happen?
No, not yet.
I love them.
This was the most recent episode.
No, buddy, I'm giving this to you in real time, bro.
We're not a cup of tea, I guess. You may not love us, but we're going to make
sure. Strong chance.
Hold on. We can't miss this interview. This is some gold.
I'm sorry.
They're doing some double talking. They are, by the way, they are gay catty mad right now at Simon. Like, the first time they did it, they're like, honey, I love to talk shit.
Now, and now like, now the second TV one, they're vets. Like, now they're TV vets.
And we go like this, like, first off, he's just impossible. He's impossible. I don't know what he wants from us. We did flip kicks. We did the splits. We sang California Dreaming.
Yeah. They're also kids. So it's like, there's something to that where it's like, I don't know.
You saying
it's
when
like,
I was 16, I was probably gay seeming?
No, not probably gay seeming. It's just a weird thing to like subject yourself to that.
To what?
Oh, to that as a 16-year-old, like to subject yourself. It's like, I don't know.
But it's not like they got drawn at random to do it. They fucking volunteered. Their parents probably had an obnoxious 18-hour car ride, however long it takes to get from Pittsburgh to here. For them to audition?
Yeah.
Oh, no, they fucking fought to be on this show.
Yeah.
And listen, they're teenagers, but this is hilarious that anytime you're not in on the old joke,
oh, yeah.
If you're not being honest, if they were like, hey, we're gay and we're twins, you'd be like, awesome, good for them.
Yeah.
Dad's holding a bottle of wild turkey. He's like, I don't know what the recipe is. Maybe I think the night I got her pregnant, I fucked her in the butt first.
Oh, man, I don't know.
I don't know
honestly,
mix
I think
some
I was,
fluids or something.
I think when we conceived him, I was thinking of professional wrestling, and that might have triggered some weird gene in me.
Boys, do you blame me for who you are?
No, Dad, we don't blame you anymore. No,
it's basically like a gypsy's curse.
Oh, Christ.
But, yeah, I mean, they are teenagers. If they're still doing this at 30, you're kind of like, you guys are being dicks.
Yeah, it is one of those things where it's like the talent, like you said, the talent show at school. It's like they do really well, but then they come into this type of environment, and it's like everybody's... I don't think a
they
lot
would
of kids
do
are
well
making
because
fun
of
they'd
be doing well because
gay anymore.
We have a weight problem in this country, and the only reason they would do good at the school talent show is because fat white women would cheer for them so hard.
I want to move like that.
Oh my God, I just want to go shopping with those two big dancing queers.
Let's see their interview.
You know, you gotta keep going.
We're not a cup of tea, I guess. I don't, you know, you may not love us, but we're gonna make the world.
But somebody over there loves you.
There's gonna be a lot of arguments later.
Yeah.
But I will win.
Oh.
Well, she's right.
Mel B.
She won because they move. And then, by the way, they move them on so casually. What are you putting up?
I saw this and I had forgotten about this guy.
Oh, yeah. This fucking... I mean, it's ridiculous. By the way, also moving on. This guy's still in the competition. Yeah, this is a giant gay black guy. Big heavy set dude. But because that moves on, dude, and some magicians have been let go.
Yeah, and they deal in the dark. They deal in the dark arts.
But I mean, like... This is in the running for $1 million residency in Vegas.
Do you know how...
And magicians have been sent home.
Do you know how angry you would
hey,
have to
be? Hey,
you
want to go to Fat Black and Gay? The, fucking...
He goes, he just mouths songs at you while he dances. I mean, that was impressive.
He's crazy impressive. They got choreographs for like cheerleaders, but he wants, it's like his time to shine now, so he's just this like fat black gay dude nailing it.
I mean, it'd be like this, some Alabama coach goes, son, you've got the agility that I've never seen before in a player. What if I told you I could get you a full scholarship to Louisiana State? You play defensive line for the Tigers.
Black Lou, be honest, you'd hit it.
What's Tyra always is like,
that's the best thing ever.
She really is Lady Nick Cannon.
She is, but like now it's also just another like it's another pretty girl on the show going like, I want to hang out with all these gay people on the show nonstop.
I'm sick of so much dick being thrown at me.
They just want to hang with these gay. They want gay people to win so bad.
Well, we'll see Mirror Image moving on. If they win this whole fucking thing, we're going to go to Vegas and see them.
I mean,
as a family.
Oh yeah, a big Vegas trip. We'll do some live bonfires from Vegas.
Dude, we'll do a live bonfire from the lobby
of the Mirror Image show.
Yeah, of the Mirror Image show.
Do you think this is for something?
But do you think this is enough popularity that they like go on the road?
No.
Because you say no pretty quickly, but there's a lot of America's Got Talent like people that try to go on the road after the show if they go far enough.
Can you look up what America's Got Talent, like not even winners, just say America's Got Talent contestants currently
I think it's going to surprise you how many. I study this every day.
Currently touring? I'd say none, almost.
Gary Veeder.
Gary Veeder, yes.
Puff the Magic Dragon, or what's his name?
Piff the Magic Dragon.
Absolutely. Got touring off of it, yeah, for sure.
But he was doing live shows anyways.
But
I mean, it's like, you know, we're comics. We know you use this as a credit. So I wouldn't be surprised if Mirror Image, if they really were like, let's do a live tour.
Oh, I mean, yeah. But I'm telling you, people will.
Like, if you're in, what's up?
I think they do have an America's Got Talent tour. You just have to make it far enough to be considered for that. So if they keep going.
Yeah, NBC's smart enough. They know how to make money.
The Clairvoyance. The Clairvoyants got touring out of it. They're with that Illusionists touring like magic show.
Ooh.
Yeah.
Tom Cotter went on tour.
Yeah, but Tom Cotter was a comic.
Yeah.
So he's already on. He's going to be
on
tour.
He didn't win it all, but he got far enough where he made the tour.
He got second.
He was touring before.
Yeah, he was touring before. He's a comic. So I'm saying like these are people that are go from zero to...
I'm talking about someone like this. I'm talking about is this big black gay guy...
Go on tour.
Go on tour now doing Sir Mix-a-Lot dances somewhere.
Fuck yeah.
Fuck yeah.
Better.
Lou's like, I'm in the fan club, so I got the presale.
Yeah. Lou goes, well, he's going on tour in February. It's a thing with his lawyers.
Me, I'm following him around the country.
Would you rather have to go see that guy or Mirror Image? Would you rather have to go see Mirror Image for an hour or Danielle Brugioli?
Take the word have to out of both of these things. You're saying I'd be upset that I had to figure out. That's a Sophie's choice of happiness.
Okay, let me tell you this right now. At Jones Beach, sold out.
Okay.
Catch Me Outside, The Experience. Danielle Brugioni. Madison Square Garden, Mirror Image. Which show do you go to?
Am I rocking great seats, either one?
Dude, you're side stage, dog.
I feel the vibe of a giant stadium, but it's intimate for me.
Intimate for you? You're side stage. Side stage.
Oh, we got Brugioli playing JB. Jones Beach?
Yeah, sold out Jones Beach.
By the way, that was the daylight.
Beautiful.
Beautiful day.
Daylight today.
It's not hot.
No.
Not humid.
No.
It's nice out.
Get some sea mist.
The breeze is coming off, but
it's nice.
It's not low tide, so we're not getting that stink.
Not stink. No swamp. You're getting fucking... And she's got a...
They've allowed drinks at this one.
Yeah.
Some of the shows, they let you drink.
You know what? They won't for Buffett. They will for Catch Me Outside.
Yeah, okay. So Catch Me Outside.
So Danielle Brugioli, you get a live show with booze.
What's the ticket price?
Don't worry. You're comped.
I'm comped.
You're comped. Everything's cool.
But I want some other people to go. What's the ticket price?
I mean, for front row?
Yeah.
Brugioli, mm-hmm. $90?
It's a steal. It's a steal. That's fine. Say no more.
Okay.
And now we're talking.
You know what? I'm sorry. I looked back. That was for Upper Deck. I'm sorry. I feel terrible.
What are we doing down
300
in the box?
390 for the box.
In the box?
In the box. I take it. Celine Dion prices, dog.
That's stiffer.
She got that Celine Dion price.
That's stiffer. 200 more bucks, you see, you could probably stay on stage with Barbara Streisand. That's Brugioli's situation. And now we got Mirror Image.
Sold out. Garden. Good luck getting tickets. You can't. People are fighting their family for it. Twins are fighting for tickets.
It's because the venue's too small.
Too small. They wanted him to do MetLife, but they said that they couldn't get the lighting right.
We're indoor performers. No,
I'm just kidding. Yeah, of course I'd love to do a stadium, like on the moon. No, I'm just kidding. We can't do that, but hopefully it happens one day. I believe Elon Musk will make it happen.
If anyone was going to perform in outer space, it'd be us.
So you see them at the Garden.
Yeah,
tickets are $1,000.
$1,000.
General admission. But you're side stage, dude.
But I'm getting the Brugioli experience. There might be a meet and greet. There might be a hug.
With Brugioli. She might threaten to fight you.
She might threaten to fight you, but there's also a hug.
But I
get close enough maybe to say something as a mom. Mirror Image backstage is going to be a little depressing. I'm going to see the dad. I'm going to feel bad for the dad.
But you also get to meet both of them.
True.
So, you know.
It's true.
What do you like? Two?
I kiss around and tell, just do back and forth jokes with them and let them.
Oh, God, they have
weird
so much
speech
fun.
Patterns on me.
I watch their weird speech patterns. You have so much fun watching their weird speech pattern.
Why do their singing voices sound like someone just turns the record player on 72 speed?
Cowboy Demon.
Alvin!
What do you go to? Brugioli or the Wonder Twins? Mirror Image.
Can I come back from our second break? Can I come back from our second break and say? I gotta really think this out. That's a lot. That's a big difference. $1,000, but it is the Garden. You know, you want to be there. For Mirror Image's premier performance.
Yeah.
Brugioli at the Jones Beach, though, man. I just feel like if I'm really get to be like side stage like that, to look out and just see all the lights.
Yeah, but
the audience, all the phones up when she does her finale.
Oh, I will tell you though that Madison Square Garden is packed with the best of the best, the elite, art, culture, music. That's so funny.
Jake, what are you saying?
Drinking at Jones Beach.
We already covered this.
Yeah.
We said though this is a drinking night. They're letting it happen.
They're letting it happen for the
they let you drink at Oddball too. Oddball tour get allowed drinking. Some shows they do, some shows they don't. He's saying this one particularly, Brugioli, live at Jones Beach. He's saying they're pulling.
I heard it's like Springsteen in like 81. Like,
oh yeah, she's not leaving the stage till she plays all the hits.
Yeah, she's doing all the hits. Fuck you, fuck your family.
I mean, everyone knows that one. Best intro in all of rock.
I heard she rarely,
in all soft rock history.
Oh, I heard she rarely does it live.
That's no filter, by the way. That is no filter. That is straight. That's home recording.
Yeah. I wrote that song
when I was living in New Jersey, I wrote that song, but hearing Danielle Brigioli sing it is, it's close as I can get to a religious experience.
Sometimes I gotta go back to that place and remember the time that I was fucked up. I was all, my mom had me all fucked up.
I remember.
And then some Twitter messages were getting me all fucked up.
I said, I don't know what I can do with all this anger, but I turn it into a song. It's all fucked up. Catch me outside. How about that?
I'm gonna hit you with an acoustic version of All Fucked Up.
Take it, Stevie.
All right, we're gonna take a break.
In the homeland.
You got me fucked up. You got me fucked up.
Got me fucked up.
Got me all fucked up. Dildo bike.
I'm all fucked up. Catch me outside.
How about
catch me outside.
How about that?
I miss you, big man. Get me outside.
Man, it ain't the same.
And now, back to the Bonfire with Big J. Okerson and Dan Soder.
Yeah!
I like harmonizing with that chorus a lot.
Fucking nailed it.
Yeah. I think I did nail it.
Hanson, because it's family music on the Bonfire. Comedy Central Radio, Sirius XM 95. I'm Dan Soder. That's Big J. Okerson.
Okay.
We're watching Mirror Image.
Okay.
Okay. And they're a family. No, really a band. Are you breaking news? Yeah, this just came up.
Is this breaking news? This is happening as we speak?
Jacob, how old is this?
The post is today.
It was posted at 6:55 a.m. today.
Oh. So, okay. So it's not breaking news.
No.
A message on Sinead O'Connor's Facebook post. Bonfire News! Hi, I'm Chip Robson. And coming in, Sinead O'Connor is safe following an alarming suicidal Facebook video posted from a New Jersey motel.
I got to tell you, I've done a lot of searching, and I found out that nothing compares to you.
I've came to New Jersey to die.
What's the point?
I want to die in New Jersey. The opposite of Ireland.
Nothing compares to you. Fort Lee, New Jersey.
If you've ever been in an upside-down world, you'd understand that that's what New Jersey is to Ireland.
It's the opposite. It's me, Sinead O'Connor, not the lead singer of the Cranberries.
Yeah. Oh, you really wish the Cranberry girl wouldn't have cut her hair.
Hey, everybody. I'm posting at Sinead's request to let everyone know who loves her. To know she is safe and she is not suicidal. She's surrounded by love and receiving the best of care. She asked for this to be posted knowing you are concerned for her. I won't respond to any questions, so please understand. I hope this comforts those of you who are concerned. But what's the video? And I like to go, don't be concerned. He goes, I'm going to kill myself. Yeah. I'm nothing but suicidal.
As anything, the only... Here's the video.
I've been fighting like all the millions and millions that I know I'm going to stay alive every day. Which I'm doing because I love the people that are doing this to me. I'm not staying alive for me. For me, if it was me, I'd be gone. Straight away back to my mom.
Oh, Jesus.
Wow, that's Irish singer Sinead.
Oh, wait, we'll keep going with that? Who's...
Seemingly calling out for help in a 12-minute video she posted on Facebook.
Hold on, pause it. What a dickwad. Seemingly calling out for help? She was extremely calling out for help. Sinead O'Connor, who seems to be in a bad spot. But what's she wearing? And that's where I fucking... That's that voice.
Perhaps we'd care more if she had hair. Maybe long hair would make her more appealing to find out if she's gonna die soon.
People are like, what do you think Sinead O'Connor looks like? And I'm just like... Like a guy.
No. Like G.I. Jane.
No, it was a movie, but probably not. Okay. Hit point.
Day, alleging she was suicidal and urging family to contact her.
Jesus.
O'Connor posted the emotional plea from a travel lodge in New Jersey saying she was...
I mean, if things aren't rough, you throw in the word travel lodge and that's where suicide becomes an option.
And then she goes and goes, I'd like a room, please.
I'd like a room to meet my maker.
Listen, lady, this is the travel lodge, okay?
give me your credit card and your driver's license.
Look at me asking questions. That's why we keep the, that's why we keep hardwood floors so the blood doesn't soak in.
Can you please do it by the drain? My nephew's working this evening. He's a young boy. I don't want him to discover the body.
As she's checking in, she goes, I'd like a room with a nice view. She goes,
how are you going to do it?
Do what? She goes,
well, listen, honey. I've been working at this travel lodge by the New Jersey Turnpike for over 25 years.
Sinead O'Connor walks through the door. You know she's getting ready to office up for the goddamn travel lodge.
People come to this travel lodge for two reasons. To butt fuck and to die. And, honey, you ain't with a mister.
Let me tell you something. My ex-boyfriend Lou Whiskey's been here for both.
So, let's get to the end of the story. Then we'll have our bonfire tie-in.
There and that she suffered from three mental illnesses.
Oh.
Late Monday night, an update was written on the singer's Facebook from an alleged friend saying they were posting on O'Connor's behalf and that she is safe and not suicidal. Going on to say, quote, she is surrounded by love and receiving the best of care. She asked for this to be posted knowing you are concerned for her. I won't respond to any questions, so please understand. I hope this comforts those of
you. If it wasn't for potatoes, I'd be dead already meeting me mother.
Oh. I just want to see the whole video of her freaking out.
All right.
You can probably find that somewhere.
Yeah, all right, Christine. I didn't know you want to go the deep cuts on her fucking suicidal thoughts.
No. Christine can't come that fast. Christine's like, she needs the whole vid.
She goes, I don't know. This is kind of like when you put your cursor over a video and you see some previews.
Oh, Irish sadness. Irish sadness. I just don't know if I want to live anymore. She goes,
oh, that's it. That's some real regret with life.
I had it all at one time, and now I have nothing. Failure.
Top of the mountain.
Oh, man, failure. Failure.
I used to be on... I was the musical guest on Saturday Night Live. Well, here's the bonfire tie-in to all of this. Jacob brings up the clip. And immediately, who pipes up? DJ Lewitsky. You know that hotel, that travel lodge.
Yeah, I've had sex in that fucking Congress Inn. I think it was called, this is one night next to it called the Jade East. So I've been around those.
This is travel lodge.
Yeah, but they changed names. I know exactly where it is. It's on Route 46 East and West.
Not just any sex.
He goes, well, they changed names after Carl sold it. Carl was a good dude. Always gave me a fair hourly rate.
He had a fight club in the basement. I can't talk much about it.
Grew weed in room 108. But
well, Ryan, no narc. So you've had sex in this hotel.
Yeah, they still rent rooms by the hour there, and it's for drug addicts and for prostitution and for DJ Lou.
Yeah. Did you ever sleep there for comfort?
No, you would never do that.
Can we call them and see if Sinead O'Connor's still there, if we can get put through to her room?
Yeah, I mean, it's really irresponsible. It's cash only. I don't even know if they have phones anymore.
They go, she dead. They go, what? She go, oh, yeah, she dead.
Make no mistake about it, that bitch dead. I seen a dead bitch, and that bitch is dead.
I wrapped her up in a carpet, tossed her in the dumpster. That bitch dead.
Black Will, can you call this travel lodge, please, and see if we can get...
Say, you're looking for the O'Connor room?
Yeah, the room DJ Lou had butt sex in the 90s.
In the 90s? Yeah. The Clinton administration. You're fucking blowing holes.
Yeah, that's when
a-holes over.
That's when it was available.
Are you getting, ask them if they're getting any kind of complaint, any noise complaints from her room?
You know what's odd about Sinead? She's very upbeat, and she goes in the room, she goes, there's been terrible things that have happened in this room.
She goes, at continental breakfast, she seemed fine.
Yeah. I laid down and shut my eyes. I saw the same man twice having butt sex in this room.
Boy, they got the pancake batter in a little cup. And you pour it into the waffle griddle.
They have a whole waffle station.
You want to know another fun fact?
There is a waffle station?
There's no waffles. There's no breakfast. There's just the terrorists from 9/11 got caught. They were living in those same rooms.
So really? You're saying Sinead O'Connor's probably working for the IRA.
Yeah.
Building bombs in there.
That's what you said. Blown away style.
I'm going to blow this place up. If it wasn't for the people that love me, I'd blow myself up with it.
And he goes, I found a sex log from one Lewitsky.
Are we calling? Have we called yet?
No, Parsippany, no. It's going to be in South Hackensack.
Dope.
And are we sure this is the same one?
Well, there's a string of them. They're all together. So she's got to be in one of them. One of them's called the Jade East. One of them's called the Congress Inn.
One of them's called something else fucking smutty.
Oh, wow.
And you're sure it's one of those four?
Yeah, everybody knows that's where you go for drugs and hookers.
Okay.
Okay.
It's a little...
Jacob, are you walking out because you're so upset about this?
Are you going to be worried that if we look it up from Google Maps, we're going to see a picture of you?
Going
Were you there the day Google Maps went by?
He goes, oh, no. Oh, no. That's my home base. That's where Jake does all his dirty deeds. That's where the travel lodge where it goes down. I tell all my lady friends, meet me at the travel lodge.
Google Maps update, just picture of me outside this place. I swear to God, I just was lost. I needed a
What you don't direction. See is the 4 pounds of sweat that I lost. Fuck it. So you...
I'm the only guy who could fuck this girl. Everyone's a fucking...
Oh. He didn't have the headphones on. He wouldn't have known. Oh, there it is. Edited.
Too many fucking faggots in this city.
He heard it. He heard it through our headphones.
I beat it.
There it is. So, I mean, she's got to be down and out if you're on a fucking travel lodge on Route 46.
Oh, it's fine. It's 2 stars.
She's living. She's still living above 1 star.
Oh, look. There's a fucking... They proudly serve Starbucks coffee in the lobby.
I don't know. Poor Sinead O'Connor.
You feel bad for her? Yeah,
she's I mean, dude, that's like fucking... Up. When you put that shit out like that on Facebook, you're in a real bad place.
I put out shit like that on Facebook.
Suicidal videos?
Not on video.
Not in a long time, you haven't.
Huh?
Not in a long time, you
Wait,
haven't.
What are these status updates that I never found
Jay's
out about?
Jay's got these like weird negative emotional things on... Like, he never uses social media, and then every once in a while something dark would pop up. I'm like, take it down!
A negger and a hater.
Now I have just a hotline you can call, and it's just my negativity of the day.
You go, hey, it's Jay. What's up?
What's up, little lambs? You know, hey. What are my fans calling?
Hey, little lambs. It's me, the herder, Jay.
Hey, lambs.
Anyways, life is pain.
No answer? Probably been getting cold. Why do you think Mariah Carey's holding everybody hostage in the lobby?
Nobody
Breaking
knows.
News. Mariah Carey. Mariah Carey. This is just it. Sinead O'Connor's holding everybody hostage in the lobby.
I'll kill everyone. I'll kill them all. I want to see Mirror Image live at the Garden.
I'm sending me mother up some help.
Yeah, dude, that's a bad place to be in, to put a video up like that. I never knew you had emo.
Travelodge,
like
sitting in a puddle of loose fucking muck.
No, dude, that carpet is crusty.
Oh, hell yes.
Okay, nothing a vacuum cleaner can do about that.
Last time Lou fucked there, he had to bring a boombox with a Def Leppard tape.
He goes, let's just hit play.
I painted those walls.
DJ Lou.
Dope. With your DJ goo.
No. Hey!
She was so cute, huh?
Yeah.
At the end of the 80s there? She had a shelf life, though, huh?
Irish women drop off pretty quick.
Now she looks like fucking Jeremy Irons.
Oh, McLean keeps the bottle. Where he was wasn't Jeremy Irons the bad guy in Die Hard 3? Simon says, I'm going to kill myself in a hotel. Yesterday, we were an army without a country. Today, we decide which country to buy.
Jeremy Irons.
Hey, McLean, keeps the bottle.
Good question, Sam McLean. Is the travel lodge only for bald people?
It's a great question, Sam McLean. They go, walk it back to the parking lot, follicles. We don't serve your kind here. Go back to the green jade next door. They take hairy motherfuckers.
Hey, follicles.
Get the fuck out of here, follicles.
Hey, head and shoulders.
Head and shoulders. Beat it, hair
not
club.
Welcome.
Hey, I'm not only the president, I'm also a client. Beat it, hair club for men.
Everyone, I've shaved my head in the parking lot. Can I come in now?
Can't believe I haven't shaved me yet in years, but I'm feeling pretty good.
Of course you can. I loved you as the voice of Scar in Lion King. That was Jeremy Irons, right?
Jeremy.
I don't mean to publicly IMDb him, but the guy's been in some iconic roles.
Oh, the guy's fantastic. Jeremy, J. Irons?
J. Irons?
Dangerous Liaisons?
That fucking, yeah, he had some real tank top confidence in Die Hard with a Vengeance.
Oh, old guy with great runner's body?
Yeah.
The guy still bikes actively?
Old man runner arms.
Oh, man, he's got old man biking body for sure.
Yeah.
Long muscle, like long veiny muscle.
Yeah, Lance Armstrong muscle.
Those biceps that go from like his shoulder to his,
wrist
pit. His elbow pit.
Well,
no answer to any of these places.
Nah.
Lou, how'd you make your reservations?
Show up.
Just pull up.
6 months in advance.
I went to the doctor and guess what he told me. That's actually a Prince song. Everyone knows that, right?
Yeah.
Yep.
But he never really, did he record it ever?
I don't think so. I was just trying to look that up.
I think he sang it live.
It's weird because when you think of Nothing Compares to You as a Prince song, you're like, oh yeah, it's perfect. That is a Prince song.
No, I think she nails it.
Yeah, but when you hear her sing it, you can hear Prince. Like, did he arrange it too?
I hate doing this on radio shows, and we don't have to watch it all. But just for anyone who goes out there, look up the American Dad when they try to make Steve cry by singing Nothing Compares to You. It's one of the funniest things ever.
Oh, this is on Ellen? 7 hours,
13 days. Oh, Prince.
All right, is he using a Christopher Titus mic? Oh, this is not, you're not playing the TV one.
God, he's fucking good. See? I can hear that. Just listen. You can tell. Man, Prince really did sometimes look like a hot mom.
Hell yeah. Like Liza Minnelli got it together.
You come pick up his hot daughter, and you go, oh, you age well.
I'll tell you what he does have. The same haircut Christine had when I met her.
Christine had Prince.
Now, I like hers better.
Really?
I do.
I like hers more.
Hers is so sad. This isn't sad, really.
He's got some balls and some cock.
Really? You like this better with the trombone?
No. But I'm just, for the sake of argument.
You're just trying to get yourself ready for the fact that Sinead O'Connor's going to kill herself today.
Oh, lady sax player looking like a Congress lady.
Yeah, really. Well, we did it. We found the least sexy thing a woman can do.
Play saxophone.
Wail the sax.
God, look at that. That's Janice.
my girl is so fucking hot.
One more time.
Watch her blow.
He goes, one more time for Leslie. That was just a fart. I did a fart noise.
So I guess Sinead O'Connor is not okay?
I don't know. We'll figure it out. But let's take our last break. When we come back, maybe some Jimmy Buffett, maybe some celebrity big dick list. What do you want to do?
We have so many fun things to do.
Yeah.
All right. We'll take our last break, then. I don't give a shit.
All right. Don't yell at me about it.
I don't give a fuck.
I'm just saying we can go to the end of the show and have fun.
All right, then.
Are we fighting like Mirror Image?
God.
Yeah, but seriously, I know.
Dan, I know. It's like, seriously, you try to take over the show. I'm just kidding.
Let's take a break.
And now, back to the Bonfire with Big J. Oakerson and Dan Soder.
Down, boy.
Jacob's wailing over there. He loves it.
Ah, it's the Bonfire, Comedy Central Radio, Sirius XM 95. I'm Dan Soder. That's Big J. Oakerson. And we play Glenn Campbell because he has passed away. The Rhinestone Cowboy.
Just a few hours ago
died.
Jacob.
R.I.P. Glenn Campbell. Jacob's visibly upset.
Yeah. And he's singing that. He loves this song. I always forget that you're into a bunch of shit I would never guess.
NASCAR, Glenn Campbell.
Baking.
This is good country.
Ranch living. Huh?
This is good country.
It's fine. I'm not arguing the level of the time. I'm just saying, like, I forget you're into, like...
Yeah.
I forget you want to be a
shark?
Cowboy.
A rhinestone cowboy.
Jacob,
you want to be a rhinestone cowboy. Christine nailed it. You want to be a rhinestone cowboy.
And now I can.
You
want to
wear
be.
Bolo ties? You have bolo ties. Without a doubt. You own bolo ties.
Do not.
You don't even own one? I'm going to get you one.
Fuck yeah.
With a Bonfire logo in the middle of it.
I'd wear it. We'll go with my shirt when we go back to Moon Tower.
Oh, fuck Moon Tower. on a Monday when you present Debadoo with our gift.
Oh, we have such a gift coming.
We got to talk about that.
It's been posted, right? The picture that we've posted.
Yeah, before. We premiered it at Moon Tower.
The super, super sensual.
Chris Rogers.
Extraordinary.
Is it Rogers or Rogers?
Rogers.
Rogers. Chris Rogers.
Amazing fan artist. And
amazing artist. Did a painting during our live show of Sexy Jacob.
And so sexy.
He's sending the picture to us, and we're going to have Jacob present it to Deb and Ben as an apology gift.
Apology? Yeah, you know.
Yeah, just for bothering them over the years.
Gave him the biz a little bit.
We're going to leave him alone for
now. You were annoying as fuck the last time.
I apologize for nothing.
Actually, or what I'm also willing to do.
The fumes?
To do with it. I'd almost though, but I would do this.
Put it in the studio.
Just put it up in the studio. It's literally hanging on the wall of the studio and just see what the people address it or not.
I mean, there's so much space.
If Fuglesang complains about it, I'd be like, oh, that's his R flair to it.
But can I tell you right now? That's the purpose.
You know what? That's our power strip.
Yeah. Jay, if we put the photo right there, you can look at it the whole time above my head. I can see it right as I walk in. Mm-hmm. People who are walking down the back hall.
Well, I get some. I bet we're going to have a lot more pylons blocking that window once that picture gets here. Jacob's going to black out everything we have here.
Yeah, like it's another fucking lap dance.
I, big, big fan of putting it up in the studio, just putting it up.
Yeah.
I'll put the hammer and the nail myself. No one else has to
explain. I know that you can't because they're like cloth walls.
You can't. Nothing goes up here.
There's a building rule where you have to call facilities to bang in any nail.
Really? Cool. Well, we'll call facilities.
Oh, cool.
We'll call them up.
We'll go get facilities on the horn.
Oh, right. Dude.
How about double-sided tape?
Or what if we just put it up like this on this side of the window for Deb and Ben? Yeah. So we face it towards them.
I think it becomes an outward-facing piece in the room. Yeah, I like that.
Yeah.
Good idea.
Yeah, to Deb and Ben.
Absolutely.
Jacob looks really ethnic in that painting, right?
You do.
Why does he look Spanish?
You look like a bandito.
His mustache. They gave him a lot more mustache.
Look, his nose, though. That's not Jacob's nose.
You know what? I think he nailed the nose with paint.
Yeah, dude, that's a great picture, Lou.
He looks Spanish.
His top shelf. You're right, though. He does look like a fucking, like he should be on a coffee bag.
Absolutely.
Hello, I am Jacob, and these are my coffee beans.
It's me, Jake, if you want to leave message.
I just came from Jalisco with only the finest coffee beans. Sometimes I ride to the villas. The children, they grab at me, and I say, no, 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 mijo. I will bring you the real coffee beans.
I up on my burro,
and I am
go on my way.
I am sensual cowboy Jacob. No.
Rhinestone cowboy.
No, yeah. I am the rhinestone cowboy. My gun is my penis. I'm a root.
El Ronstonio cowboy.
How did you, Jacob, how did you find the celebrities with a big dick?
Christine
found
them.
How'd you find them? Just like you went up to them and asked them? Yeah, or you paid them? Or what'd you do?
You go, can I see it? Can I see it? Guys, just let me take a look real quick. Hey, Uncle Milty, let me see it.
We found a list of biggest celebrity dicks.
Where's this list from? Because we were scheduling up some possible interviews, and we were talking about trying to get Huey Lewis on and
we decide how we'll do our interviews based on how big your dick is.
That's a Jay rule. You know, I'm up for it, but this list is, as they say, all right. So what is it? Hollywood's biggest. What's it on? What website is this?
Popdust.com.
That sounds
good. Oh, Popdust.
Oh, of course. They broke Watergate. I remember Popdust.
Didn't they open up? Didn't they really? Weren't they the thing that really cracked the Lufthansa?
Yeah, I think that. And it was like, I think, what was that movie about the Boston paper busting up? Spotlight. I heard that's based on this. It's on Popdust. Hollywood's, somebody has to write that.
Hollywood's biggest dicks in no particular order.
Like they're going to get offended. They should do them in an order.
It doesn't say how big they are.
It just says who they
are. None of them?
No, it just says who has big dicks.
Well,
no.
why don't we look up on another page you could constantly be looking up. Like, because number one here we have, in no particular order, David Beckham.
Makes sense. He's a European soccer star.
Who would make him a world-class athlete and give him a giant schlong, says the article. So they are wondering themselves.
He's got a big one. You know that.
And so he has a whiny girl voice. That's what makes it fair.
What?
He has a whiny girl voice.
Is that true?
You know, it doesn't seem to care.
It's going to have me looking at
anyone.
Dude, you know who's going to have me? It's going to have me looking at dudes with whiny, like, Jacob, what's up, man? You're off.
Yeah, I bet Jacob's got a fucking Coke can, for sure. A big, fat, round dick. I know he does.
Like a round stone cowboy.
Like a round, fat dick cowboy. He's so handsome, though, huh? That David Beckham?
And everyone else see it, you know.
Oh,
yeah. Everyone else see
the voice, though.
Wow. Also, this is my lovely wife. Oh, that's Harry Styles. We have the same voice.
No, we're so excited.
You know, so the I have a new sports line in Jim Jerry. We're seeing inside. The voice of a 67-year-old woman from Liverpool.
Who's after David Beckham? Do we ever find out how big his dick is or any clay? I know it doesn't say it in that.
Also, my left pectoral muscle looks like it's evaporating.
But can we look up on another website if they have the actual dick sizes?
Hello.
Who's next after him? Chris Brown.
Yeah.
Now, I don't have to go find out how big Chris Brown's dick is. We've seen that picture on the show before.
Yeah.
He's got a big old, it's thin, it's long. Black Lou wasn't super impressed with it, if I recall. But it's thin, but it's a thin, long, soft. That's something.
Which, hey, he's just got big dick confidence that he can, because he can dance well and he hits women and they'll take him back.
Yeah.
That's like...
No, I think you're right.
You know what I mean?
The dance, the dick, and the...
And the close-handed hitting.
And the close, yeah. That'll bring a chick back. Oh, that'll bring a bitch back.
What if I told you half the damage was done with my dick?
If I can't convince you to come back with these body rolls, maybe I can convince you like this.
Nope. All right, who's next?
Oh. David Cassidy.
Hey!
That's very random.
All right.
Somebody used to call him, his brothers called him Donk, as in donkey, and the people have told him he is blessed in the trouser department. He's got a lot of trousers. Maybe that's what that means.
Yeah.
Hey, mijo, why you built like a burro?
Wow, hang on a second. So Willem Dafoe is the next one.
Okay, which makes sense because of that face.
Yeah.
God would give you a fucking huge...
That's fair.
God's like, I'm sorry, I'm going to make you look like a skeleton.
If he makes your mouth open to your ears, he has to give you a big dick. He's so well endowed that in a shitty movie that I watched not too long ago called Antichrist, they did a penis cutting scene. Willem Dafoe...
I don't think it's really him.
What? Willem Dafoe?
Yeah, somebody said Willem Dafoe. I don't think that's him. That can't be him.
Maybe not. But anyway, could we... I think
I think that is. Him dancing around at the Bonfire, SXM, on Twitter, Instagram, and Snapchat to see what the fuck we're talking about. Someone had an old 70s video.
It says that they had to use a body double for his dick because his bulge is so huge... That everybody got confused when they saw it? I don't know.
Alright, that sounds like a guy that made up a lie to his cousin.
Yeah.
Like, oh, my dick's so big that I got like confused.
It made like four people run away. They tried to tell a cop that there was a sand snake.
They said it was illegal.
A sandworm.
They said I couldn't have it. It was illegal. Next guy.
I couldn't have it.
Danza!
Yeah!
Tony D is on the list. He makes cheeses and he got a big old dick.
Oh, what? Wait a second. There's a picture, a full frontal naked picture of him fresh out of the shower and showing off a mammoth man piece? Where is that?
How did you not know that, Jay? As a Danzer fan.
A Danzorian?
A Danzorian. A Danz... I'm trying to think of what his nation would be. Danzano?
The Danzonos? That's a big dick. Yeah, I guess I can see.
Tap dancing.
Yeah. He's confidence. You're right.
What you said on an old episode.
One confident guinea.
Yeah, exactly. And that's, there's a reason being.
That's it. He's swinging huge piece.
Yeah. So he's like,
can we find that picture of him getting out of a shower?
I'm trying.
She's going deep. Get it? All right.
Fresh out the shower. Try to bing Tony Danza mammoth man piece.
Yeah. It's like the opposite. Scene in Who's the Boss when Angela was coming out. Wow. All right. Jesus.
You found it?
Yeah.
How did Jacob find it so quickly?
Jacob find it. Yeah, there it is. Wait. Now, wait. Hang on. Make that picture bigger. That is a fat dick. Yeah, that's a good one.
Good for him.
Uncircumcised. He's got that weird fucking thing over. But look at Tony Dan. Look at young Danzer. Look, Christine's even making weird, like, scrunching up in her chair movements.
Yeah, she's getting all jealous of Judith Light. All
That's
right.
A big fat dick.
Dude, Dan, by the way,
Dan, I hate when you're not impressed with big fat dicks, dude.
Okay, I don't gloat over it like a Jewish mom.
Man. All right, Dan, we get it. Your dick's huge, bro.
I didn't say that. I said
it always comes back to you and your big fat dick.
No, but also when you said it, I was like, oh, wow. Like, that was my initial thing. Did I tell you I met Judith Light in passing?
No.
Yes.
And what'd you say?
I wanted to ask her. Cock. I wanted to ask her so many questions, but she was leaving, and she was very nice. She was old, like, you know, kind
of frail.
Did
you ask her if she has Moner's number?
I go, hey, Dan's piece in person. Impressive? She went.
She goes, is it? Uncircumcised.
She goes, my life hasn't been the same.
I mean, nothing that would excite you, Dan.
Shut up.
But
who's next on the list? Leo.
Oh,
of course, Leo's. They said Leonardo DiCaprio. Ask Cherry Pie Girl Bobby Brown, who told Pop Dust, his brow furrowed a little as he eased himself into me. I inhaled sharply. He was titanic.
Bobby Brown's a fucking old lady. She's from the Cherry Pie video. Who's super hot, but I mean, like,
so she fuck Leo or someone else?
I mean, when?
I hate the pun. He was titanic. Let's just say his balls were Gilbert's grape.
Let's just say he gave me some growing pains. No, I guess
yeah. Oh, him and his friends came over. I guess you could say it was Gangs of New York. she is fucking smoking hot.
She was smoking hot. But I feel like not in Leonardo DiCaprio's time. Bobby Brown at 1,005 years old.
2005 is when she fucked him?
Call it there.
We'll call it there? Oh, yeah, she had a lot of plastic surgery.
That's not
such a funny song for Tony Danza's uncircumcised.
So naked and in Speedos and fucking good for him, man. Very happy. Who's next on the list? Christine, you're writing a thesis on Tony Danza's dick? Fassbender, that doesn't surprise me. He's got big, tall, fucking fat dick confidence. What?
He's full frontal in the movie.
The sex addiction movie.
Yeah.
Yeah.
It opens up the movie.
Huge.
Gigantic. Dude, when dragging.
What
movie? Shame.
Shame. There's this German guy who worked on that movie I did. It had to be you. And I was joking around laying there because there's a scene where I was in my boxers and I was like, hey, watch out if it slips. He goes, don't worry. I worked with Michael Fassbender on something. And he goes, and I was like, oh yeah, big dick, huh? Like said something like a joke like that. And the guy goes, oh, he was very naked in the movie.
You know what? If I were you, I'd shut your fucking mouth about it.
Yeah. I go, what? He goes, you are talking too much. And it's Fassbender.
So what's the scene? Shame? Do you find that, Christine? I want to find Fassbender's
dick. Walking in his apartment.
I was looking up, by the way, DiCaprio slept with Bobby Brown when he was 19 and she was 26. I'm trying to figure out what year that was.
Yeah, that's fine.
Good for him.
Good pull for him then. He was.
That was on his way up.
Titanic.
What could you say that he was? Titanic? You will die, James Bond.
Would you say Molly Ringwald's breasts were pretty and pink?
Oh,
I'm so naughty.
Would you say Mark Wahlberg's penis caused a little bit of fear? Does he grow us? Or he gets transformed? He goes, come on, stop doing that. You know I can't get hot around robot guys.
No, come on, stop talking about my ticket for everybody. You know I get it. How I get?
You know how I get.
You know how I get?
Yeah, I get.
I get soft. And then I can't show my manhood in front of these fucking robot cars outside. Wow.
Yeah, that's a lot of fucking dick for... Wow! Is that impressed, Jay? Is that enough for you?
Thank you for overreacting. Whoa!
Oh, whoa, 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 whoa. And the fact that there's a crew there and like, and action.
Although, I'll be honest with you, he's cheating a little bit. He's a little hard.
Yeah,
it's swinging too stiff.
Yeah, you see the angle. I see exactly what you're talking about. That guy's plumped up in the back. We know
we're on to you, Fassbender.
Yeah. That's not all soft dick.
I know your plumping techniques.
Oh, and he's fluffing.
No, he's pissing.
Yeah. Flissing.
Oh, also when he's pissing, he's not hanging low. He's not hanging. All right. We got to the bottom of that. Next case.
All right. Well, yeah. His dick's big.
Who's that?
Australian singer turned British treasure Peter Andre?
What?
Received an eye-watering Gorn report from glamour model Jordan, who claimed her now ex-hubby's pork sword is the size of a large television remote control. The hands he's doing is bigger than a remote control.
Yeah, also, is that universal remote? Is that just cable remote?
Yeah, we talk about some like, thing I go by at Rite Aid because it just works. And, like, the number one's like elevated off the fucking...
Yeah, or are we talking about the one with the 17 buttons on the top where it can turn on? That's his ex-wife.
For a lot of my things, my iPad is my remote control. Does this guy have an iPad dick?
Look at... I mean, her eyes are wonky. Jay, look at this picture of his ex-wife.
Oh, yeah, he did knock her eye wonky, huh? Oh, Jordan, I don't know. She's done some, like, dirty shit. She's done some nudity. They catch her nude a lot. There's not going to be an actual picture of his dick, though, at all. It's going to be just reports from this girl. So keep going. Jamie Foxx?
Of course. Move on.
We've seen that.
Yeah.
Oh, yeah, big dick, right?
Yeah.
It is big. You're right.
Good for Jamie.
Who? Vincent Gallo's dick is not that big. He was in Brown Bunny.
It was a little close-up, so who could tell, really?
It's pretty thin. I don't know. It didn't make me feel super. Go to that Brown Bunny blowjob scene. Chloe Sevigny sucks his dick.
In real life, too, right?
Yeah.
In real life and film.
But I'm saying, like, they filmed
and
it.
And your imagination.
Oh, but I'm saying, like, they actually filmed it, right?
Oh, yeah. He blows a sticky load on her.
Weird.
I know. It's one of those few movies that have a real blowjob to completion. There's several.
Like, that are just...
I've investigated this.
But they're not porn. They're just, like...
They're not porn. It's a movie. This is like an indie flick. This is what's her face? Chloe Sevigny.
Yeah.
She sucks his dick.
Who's Chloe Sevigny?
She's
the girl
was in
from Kids.
Oh, wow. Everything.
Big Love.
Yeah, Big Love. I like that show a lot. But I guess he's got a fucking fat piece on him. Yeah, it's a big dick.
All right. Good for him.
Christine's just finishing.
I just don't get. I'm like, oh, that's just so she's done porn.
Are you edging yourself? It's not porn. It's
you edging yourself.
Well, they were a couple also at the time.
Oh, they were.
Yeah.
John Hamm, I've heard.
Oh, you heard that, John Hamm? Old news. Jay-Z, I've never heard that before.
I've heard that because one of the girls that he fucked around with went to like Smoking Gun and said that he was a terrible lover but had a giant dick.
A 1 liter Pepsi bottle.
Yep, that's the thing that I read on. When did that come out? That was like 10 years ago.
It's beyond huge. It could block the sun. a 1 liter Pepsi bottle can't block the sun. Whoever did those measurements.
She goes, 20 ounces of Sprite. You never seen that commercial?
You know, the Planet Crusher? a 20 ounce Coke Zero. The Planet Crusher. The Soul Destroyer.
I call Jay-Z's cock Galacticus.
Oh, it was another fucking.
She said Iverson can lay some pipe.
Oh, yeah?
Mm-hmm.
What did she say about AI?
I knew it.
Alan was lean and muscled.
Muscled?
Muscled. A warrior.
Was that a mistake?
Yeah.
I'm telling you, you panic when you have the glasses on,
okay.
And you think you have to nail the readings.
Okay.
So you start doing everything phonetic.
Okay.
And you just said Alan was lean and muscled, not as a joke. Yeah. A warrior with tattoos and bat's clay scars. Just looking at him, goat me excites Ed.
All right, read the real paragraph, though. His body was scrumptious.
His kiss was intoxicating, and I felt like I was melting. Oh, I'm picturing all of this. I'm picturing it, though, it's me and him.
Yeah, I know it is.
Our antics took us from one side of the bed to the other. I couldn't get enough of this man. He was so physically strong, he thought nothing of picking me up and creating the most erotic of poses.
Mm-hmm.
When my legs wrapped around AI while he holds me in the air. Give me those deep low pumps. Now I'm against the wall, just taking it like, ah.
Remember when you dropped? Remember when you dropped 40 against the Knicks?
When he finally possessed me, I was so ready. He filled me completely, and our rhythm was perfect. Allen was average in size, but his gift was girth and technique. His sliding and swerving thrusts hit me in spots I didn't know I had, and this was only round one.
Oh.
He didn't even have a big, big dick. He just knew how to throw it.
Yeah.
Now I really love AI. That's my dick. It's the AI of a thing. It's the little big man. I have a poster with all my dick injuries, though. Also. Never missed a game, though.
Never missed a game. Always fucks.
Never missed a game. I should do a pee hole video of my pee hole going, practice? We're talking about practice?
Right?
Not fucking.
Who's next on the list? Oh, that guy.
Of course he does. Yeah. Of course.
Isn't he the guy that's banging Sophia Vergara?
They're married. Mm-hmm. Yeah, so Joe Manganiello. He's the werewolf in True Blood, and that's what he's famous for. Magic Mike, I guess.
Tom Jones.
Always heard that. Everyone said that.
I was on Jim and Sam, and he was on there, and he was fucking, they didn't bring it up, but we talked about it.
If you have that fucking goofy hair your entire career and look that goofy, he's never a good-looking guy, really.
He's like, oh, these birds love my giant wang.
Yeah.
He's Welsh.
He's like a Welsh dude, and he fucking, like, just a huge, big fucking pig, apparently.
John Mayer, huh?
Oh, come on. That bothers me.
You have it all, huh?
John Mayer's been blessed with such an... According to the Kiss and Tell Girl... Enlarged penis street that he can give himself a blowjob, and he strikes me as the guy that would.
Yeah, he'd suck his own dick.
Turns out his body is a wonderland. Congrats, Mayor Penis.
But like all like Jessica Simpson and Katy Perry were all like, yeah, they like he fucked me the best.
Really?
Yeah. Like Katy Perry like said that recently where she was like, I was sexually addicted to him, and you're like, all right, good for you. Cool. Some of us are.
And a comic.
Yeah. Oh, yeah. Well, thank God those days are gone, huh?
Hey, pull your pants on and kiss you on the pussy. I'm proud of you. I want to suck your pussy.
Right.
Your one
Who's
lip,
next?
Your one lip's a little longer than the other lip.
Who's that? Oh.
Chris Isaac.
Of course. I have no problem with that. Look at those hairy arms. That guy's all man.
Yeah, this website.
I got a giant dick.
He can also give himself a blowjob. I'm okay with that one.
You'd much rather. So if you had a choice between Chris Isaac and John Mayer watching them blow each of themselves.
Oh, this guy's got the confidence to wear Lego hair.
This video is made by a guy with big dick.
Comfortable as a child as this video.
Yeah, I'm like watching this and I'm like, are you guys just really gonna fuck?
I'm in a club and I'm gonna fuck a hot girl. I'm gonna bang you. My dick's so heavy, they gotta put me inside there.
This is such... Hot people just do this on Instagram now.
I mean, this girl's beautiful. Who is this
Helena
girl?
Helena Christensen, you fucking animal.
Oh, tackled her.
No.
Oh, God, it's so alarming.
That's also my impression of Tears for Fears.
Oh, look at her. Look at her. Good job, Helena Christensen.
She held up, sort of. Is that her now?
Mm-hmm.
Were they married?
No. Go to the left.
The
white one. Yeah, that's her now. And it ain't that great.
Okay, well, that's good. That's pretty good. How old is she?
Nah, I turn her down.
Your late 40s.
That's I'll send her over to your room, Dan, because I don't want it.
What, at the travel lodge?
So she's probably 50, actually.
She's 48!
Oh my God, look how old everybody is.
Everybody!
No, this is a...
Whoa!
What? Uncensored?
No. Jesus, that's uncomfortable. All right, go next to the list. But God, what a fun walk down memory lane.
There's a walk of Everly. It's only in his dick. Remember from before? Christine, close a tab. Jesus fucking Christ.
Ewan McGregor?
I've always heard that,
that's,
too.
Well, he's naked in a lot of films. Oh, Train Spotting.
Obi-Wan's got a piece, huh? Yeah. Good for him. Next.
I heard that before. Her Neeson has a big old fucking schwanz.
But,
schwanz.
They call it Dark Man. Here's what you want. I'll tell you this. What I will give you is a giant cock.
Oh, Colin Farrell. Yeah, that's not Irishman.
Certified Angus beef right there. What you're looking at is not a way to, not a violent ending to find my daughter. What you're looking at is a baby arm holding an apple. Some people say that I have a pig's leg as a pig. If you could take it all the way down to the balls, balls deep as they say in America.
Well, you're about to get Rob Royd. That's where I put it in you.
And I just leave it. Rob Roy. You ever had it?
I heard Colin Farrell too.
You're onto my Schindler's List. I'm going to put you on a little different than Schindler's List. It's Liam Neeson's List. That's where I pop your hip out with my giant cock.
Ray J's dick was a little skinny. And now, granted, look, he's part of my favorite video clip on the internet of all times.
Kim Kardashian?
I don't like him in it. What?
With the Kim Kardashian clip?
No, Who's Got Jokes.
Oh, yeah.
No, he's a judge on Who's Got Jokes.
Oh, okay. That's hilarious.
Come on, dude.
Yeah, I'm sorry. I forgot about that.
Who's Got Jokes?
Simon Rex?
Oh, yeah. That's right. He did gay porn?
He was a former MTV VJ.
But they found he did gay porn, too?
I don't know about
I
that.
I think they did find that out. So I erected a little gay porn.
No. What a fallen world. Yeah, so those are always like, oh, wow. No, they have them. Yeah, okay. Yeah.
Let's see.
Okay.
Let's
see him work. Come on, man.
Let's see him work.
Dude.
You brought the whole topic up, Dan. Hollywood's biggest dicks. Yeah, it's a fucking good piece, man. His butthole's fine.
God, dude, how silly you have to feel jerking off like that.
By the way, I know. Oh, jerking off on all fours from behind, you gotta have a big confident dick because your balls drop down halfway into your dick.
Alright, we're good. It's just
no, do you understand what I'm saying?
Yeah.
Like it fall, like your balls come down like halfway down your dick from the bottom shot.
It's just funny to be like with your head, with your butt above your shoulders and you're like jerking off. It's just weird. Who's this guy?
Justin Thoreau. Yeah, it's Jennifer Aniston's new guy. Yeah, probably. That makes sense to me. Wait, they say, hey, wait, go back. They say, haven't you seen the jogging scene from The Leftovers?
Type in jogging scene from The Leftovers. Mm-hmm.
And Big Dick.
All right.
Well, you want to find that jogging scene. True. I don't think the character jogs a lot.
But
they
said
that jogging scene.
I heard the guy's a runner. That's all I'm saying. Dude, I'm going to be on the fucking train on the way to shows doing that. It's so bad, it's good.
Let's see this guy's meaty piece. Does a dog bite his dick? Oh, yeah. Yeah.
This is like a regular bulge. What's the big deal?
No. It was like on both. It like tugged around the sides of it. It really is show your dick off pants. Yeah, look at him bouncing around.
He tells the director, he's like, I only got two more takes or else you're going to shatter my femur.
Look at that thing.
Robin Thicke. That's, you know.
Do we have to get back to this list? Oh, no, we're almost done.
No.
It's up, yeah.
Yeah, we can power through it. Robin Thicke, who cares? Big whoop. Tommy Lee, seen it.
It's a thin dick, though.
Mark Wahlberg?
By the way, Christine's reaction was, She didn't even agree. She just went,
What? What do you want me to tell you?
Yeah, young Wahlberg probably just crush it at will, huh?
Oh, I don't think
so. I mean, Wahlberg now.
Yeah.
Yeah, he's still fucking jacked, huh?
Yeah, he's still jacked.
Yeah, different way, though. He was like he shows his age on his face, but he's aging well.
You know how much fun swimming must be when you have a body like that? Just to go swimming, just carefree, willy-nilly.
I'll just end the show. You just bum me out.
I'm asking. I'm saying because I don't know.
Just make a nice dive.
You want me to go to a Jersey Travelodge and kill myself? Then why don't you bring everybody I know and love and want to impress and then tell them, like, hey, Jay, why don't you go to the deep end of that pool without a ladder? Oh, that's my nightmare. I have to wash myself up like a fucking manatee. I have to get one leg up and then let the water just whoosh me onto the fucking concrete. I'm out of here. Ooh. All right. Christine just keeps showing me fucking Mark Wahlberg pictures while I'm expressing all my sadness.
She's on a tear. You can see Big J Oakerson this Thursday through Saturday at Magoobies in Baltimore. Go to BigJComedy.com for tickets. And then, of course, follow us at The Bonfire, SXM on Twitter, Instagram, and Facebook.
Hey, that's dope. Oh, also, I'm going Omaha Funny Bone this month now.
Ooh.
Yeah, I'm actually pretty excited about that. I've never been there before.
I heard it's a great club.
We'll see. Dan Soder's new half-hour special as part of the stand-ups is available now on Netflix. It is absolutely awesome. Go check it out. They shot a really cool series of specials there, and Dan's is absolutely a standout. And Cleveland Campers, you can catch him performing at the Accidental Comedy Festival at the end of August. That's our friend Ramon's festival, and he is awesome, and Dan's going to be there kicking ass at the Accidental Comedy Festival. You can get your tickets at accidentalcomedy.com. As always, follow us at The Bonfire, SXM on Twitter, Instagram, and Facebook for us and all of our average to huge dicks.
Yeah.
No, I was eating them on it.
Yeah, we're
going to get it.